dusk whenever the other creatures of the forest would pass the old cabin. They would shout out and call her names. Katundra is a fatty. Na-na-na-na-na-na. Or sometimes they'd cheer, "We better run away because fat Katundra might waddle over here and sit on us."
I'ma do my own thing. I'ma do me. I'ma do my own thing.
Well, good morning.
Good morning.
How are you this morning, Ruby?
I'm doing good.
It's so nice to see you. You'll see that I have atop my head a rather large conch shell. Tie me up real good tight.
Well, let's start with the things that we did in the last couple months. I'm excited.
In February, I had the pleasure of spotlighting the full Monty down at the Arts Asylum. It was directed by my wonderful boss and friend, Corey Childs. He's quite the director and is very appreciative to be a part of that production.
It was DeVille's birthday.
Oh, we should probably sing happy birthday to him, shouldn't we? All right, one, two, three.
I went to Elton John.
Elton John, was that fun?
It was amazing.
Pardon the random angle change there. You planted seeds?
I did. I planted all the seeds for the garden. I'm excited.
That's exciting. And I also got a Venus flytrap. Mm-hmm. Its name is St. Charles III, the destroyer of bugs. We also cleaned the fish tank.
It went from ooky-gooky to beautiful and blue.
Here's some footage of us cleaning the fish tank. You can really see that ASMR quality coming through.
Ew, there's a snail in here.
Sorry, I baby barfed there. March. I also had the pleasure of spotlighting Lizzie the Musical down at the Arts Asylum. It was a co-production between Faust Theater and the Arts Asylum. It was a lot of fun. You know Sarah McGuire.
I do.
She was in it. She was absolutely fantastic. It's been the first time she was on stage in 6 years. She remains incredible. We experienced the horror that was Polly D. You know, we went to Power and Light on St. Patrick's Day. And then you had something called Greek Easter?
Yes.
Explain that.
My family does Greek Easter. My grandfather is Greek Orthodox. So we celebrated that and some of our family came over from Greece.
Shout outs today. Rapid fire. Ready? Charlie.
Jack number two.
Goldie.
Public Works of Raytown.
There's your shout out. Word of the day. Word of the day is
tweezer.
An Urban Dictionary defines tweezer as
a person who is late middle age, approaching but not yet a geezer.
The default sentence is, I'm not that old yet, I'm still just a tweezer. My default sentence for old man is usually, the last time I was in office, Calvin Coolidge was president.
That's a long time ago. There we go. Perfect. We got it.
Don't worry. It's here. Now we're going to move on to our last segment of the episode, and that's Dramazon. What are we reviewing today, Ruby?
A graniteware tamale pot with steamer insert. 15.5 quarts.
Would you want one of those?
Ooh, if the results are good, I'll get it.
Well, we're about to find out. Now, Charles sent in this. It's a 1.0 out of 5 stars. Yeah, with the subject line, do not buy.
Oh.
It was posted January 9th, 2018, and it was a verified purchase. Oh. And his review is as such. After using it just a couple of times, the coating inside is burning / melting off into my food. The pot is unusable, very toxic smelling, the black tar.
Ew.
Well, everyone, have a great day. Have a great week, Ruby. Final words to the camera.
Goodbye!
See you later, everybody.